What's going on, everyone? The Rules, aka Crazy Russian 86. So now in this video, you know, like 10 or 21 left a comment, go back to Russia with a comma. Here's the reason why I'm probably not gonna go back to Russia. I have reasons for it, okay? Number one, alright? You know, I came here when I was 19 because my parents told me to do so, and I didn't know what I wanna do, so I just listened to them. And I'm like, okay, I'm just gonna do it. Because, you know, at that time, I was not really an adult, was not really mature, because I believe people who are 19 years old are not really mature to make their own decisions. So I just went with what my parents told me. And then I wanted to go back when I was 21. But my mom and my dad forced me to stay in the United States because they think it would be better for me because I'm 75% Jewish and I look like a Jew. And there is a history, there is what people believe in, that Jewish people are hated in Russia as a minority, which I didn't really face that, but this is what my parents told me, which is not true in my opinion, but this is what they believe, this is what they went through. Even though I don't give a fuck about it, but I just had to listen to it. Because, you know, I didn't know any better. I'm like, okay, I do it. So I was miserable here for first 3 years. And now I got tamed, you know, I got accustomed to it. Yes, Americans are different creatures, I agree. Because they are not focused on the same things. Like, for example, they can be pretty flaky, they have this fake politeness. You know, they're pretty passive-aggressive. Like Russians, they will tell you what's wrong with the Americans. They're not gonna say anything and they're gonna just tell you to other people. They're gonna talk shit, you know. But in the face, they're very polite, they're smiling all the time. So you think they like in reality, it's not the case. It's just the way they are. It's just the way they act. It's the way they've been taught to act. So it's the American culture. So if you're impolite, if you're rude, you're not gonna get anywhere, which is fucked up in my opinion, but this is just the way Americans are. That's why I had problem with them. And people tell me, if you tell, you know, I think, I believe, it's not good. You cannot argue with anybody. Not just your bosses, but you cannot argue even with your girlfriend. Because I dealt with it, you know. You're being argumentative, you know. You say stuff, they just get all upset and shit. It's how people are. So, can't say what you think, can't really argue with anyone. But on the flip side, Americans are hardest people because, you know, they kind of better atoning themselves. And they are, you know, Americans also, they're good at like quick decisions. So, you know, like, there are certain things Americans are stronger, right? But in certain things, they like, you know, their fake politeness and their kind of flakiness. It's kind of tough to deal with, you know, things like that. And also Americans are almost more into luxury, the comfort. You know, Americans are, you know, more into religion, by the way. So there's a lot of differences, but like I said, I'm still gonna stay in the United States because, see, like, I shouldn't have left Russia to begin with. But since I did it, I'm not gonna change my life for the third time because this is bad. Changes, constant changes, going here and there is bad. It's very unhealthy. Okay? Because people have only one life. And it's like this. If you live in Venus and you go to Mars, for example, right? The same thing. If you live in Russia, you go to the United States. It's like you're going to another planet. It's like you're going to another world. So you have to learn another language, another ways of being, another ways of communicating to people, another ways of dealing with people. And then you're gonna go come back. What's gonna happen? You're gonna readjust again. Then all your friends who like, in my case, who like teenagers, late teens, now they're like 30 years old with family, and here I'm coming, starting everything from fucking zero, okay? That's gonna suck. Because I'm gonna be all alone, I'm gonna start everything from scratch. So how many times can you start everything from scratch? You're gonna adjust again, because all your buddies who before used to just, you know, have sex, you know, drink beer, and, you know, live with their parents, now they, you know, gonna be driving cars, living by themselves, having families, having kids, and developing as they are. And here I'm coming in. And they have jobs, they have, you know, things to do, and they have no time for me, because time, when, you know, when I was in Russia, when, you know, people just having fun and drinking all the time, you know, just go to school, and then you have free time, you just get fucked up, and so over. Now people have families, having kids and stuff. They have no time just to, you know, to drink with me all the time, you know, just find maybe 2-3 days a month. So, because then, you know, they have obligations. And then they also have their new friends, you know. That's the thing, though. And here in America, I have friends. Yes, most of my friends, I don't have that many friends, and most of my friends are not really Americans. They're not really typical American people, I'm gonna say that. I have friends, you know, from Venezuela, Iraq, Africa. I have one of my Russian friends who lives in New York, you know. So I don't really friend with typical Americans. And then I have friends who like much older than me, you know, so. So of course, you know, in America, if you're weird, you can find people who just like you and blend in. But my point is, with typical American kids who are like into, you know, American stuff like Super Bowl, always watching football, always watching American shows, you know, it's gonna be hard for me to be friends with such kind of people. Because I'm not into the same thing as they are. And you know, they're either religious of the 80s, they're into science or whatever, or they're into American shows, like I said, you know. And here I am, I don't know nothing about what they're into. Because I'm coming from Russia, from different world. And if I give them, for example, some Russian music to listen to, they think that's weird. Because it's not what they're accustomed to. That's why in America, you know, Chinese people with Chinese community, African people with African community, Jewish people, okay, there are American Jews, but they're still different from me. Because American Jews, they grew up in American culture. And I grew up in Russian culture. Now, we can talk about me having disability, for example, okay. Let's say, you know, whatever. I dealt with people with autism. And I tell you, I cannot fit in even there, because, you know, it's a spectrum, and people, even with autism, they have different problems. People with disabilities, they're different, you know. So it's like, see, it's not all about being weird, being Russian, it's just, you know, it's different much of variables which makes me too different from everybody else, you know. And you know, being different means being lonely, it means, you know, not being accepted by the society. So I just, you know, this is just me. I'm just never gonna be accepted by the society. I just have to deal with things. I have to deal with the fact that, you know, there's not too many people's gonna accept me. And I'm gonna deal with, you know, with all kinds of different people who like also eccentric like I am. That I'm never gonna be able to deal with, you know, mainstream people. So, it's just the way it is. So I might as well just stay in this country, because you know what? In Russia, I'm gonna face the fact that people not gonna have no time for anything either, for different reasons. Yes, it's gonna be easier for me, but you know, since I've been here for 8 years, I just have to deal with it and just find myself here, you know, trying to adapt and shit. Of course it sucks, because Russian people are made to live in Russia. But again, I'm 75% Jewish. And Jewish people, this is how they live. They have to adjust and adapt to every culture and preserve their own heritage. In my situation, I don't give a fuck. So I can do whatever the fuck I want. That's just my opinion. Because I'm all by on my own, I'm all by myself. I'm just here for money. That's it. Sure, the fact that I came to this country, it's not healthy. Because you know what, being Jewish, being from Russia, living in the United States, that's too multicultural, it's too unhealthy. It's not good for the people's psyche, okay? It's not healthy, because you know, certain people are made to live in certain habitat, you know? But this world is unhealthy. This world is a very unhealthy place to be. It used to be healthy, but now it's not. This multiculturalism and globalization, you know, making people pretty much, especially in America, in this melting pot culture, they're just awful, you know. It's all kind of weird things, and it just kind of makes people, it makes difficult for people, you know. You have to just like blend in. And that sucks. So. Yeah, that's all I'm gonna say, people. You know, like I said. Being foreigner sucks. If you weren't born in Russia, you should live and die in Russia. If you're born in America, you should live and die in America. But if you were born in Russia and to live in America for fucking 8 years, you might as well just keep living in America, because if you're gonna go back to Russia or to another place, it's gonna be another transition, it's gonna be painful again, and you're gonna put your life on hold again, and everything gonna suck even worse. So, it's like this. Yes, the situation sucks, yes, it's fucked up, but you know what? If you're gonna change it, it's only gonna be worse. So I might as well just stick to where I'm at and just focus on growing and developing myself where I'm at instead of changing my environment. So that's just my opinion. So that's my response to you motherfuckers who tell me to go back to Russia, okay? Now you can tell me what you think about my response to what I think. Peace out later.